When putting together a logo design proposal document, one of the most crucial things we can do is include in-situ visuals, because they help us demonstrate to a client a logo design working in real-life instances. Here I am in Illustrator, and this is a typical logo proposal document I will put together for a client. Now, as part of the proposal document, I will often include in-situ visuals. For this project, I'm working on a logo design for a music festival, and at the end of the document, you can see I have a few pages showing how the logo can be used in a series of visuals. One in particular is a poster scene. Now, for many logo design projects, I would imagine a logo would be used in a format like this. Now, I love showcasing my posters in cool street scenes like this because it gives a nice real impression of how a logo design may be used in a large format. And the best thing about this is you can do this absolutely free. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate a technique to easily superimpose your logo design into a really cool free poster street scene in Photoshop. So let's get into it. So here I am with my logo design process checklist. Once we have created our logo designs and we have checked each task, we can now move into step one in phase four. So the first step in the present logo designs phase is place logo into in-situ visual examples. Now, using in-situ visuals like this in your proposal can really bring your design to life and wow your client. Now, it can be time consuming and difficult to get that perfect shot yourself to include in your proposal. And if you're on a project with a tight budget or timeline, you may want to spend more time on other parts of the process. One method to save time is to use free stock images. A little time searching for the right image can save you hours of work, which will ultimately save you money. For this template, we are going to use a free image from UNSPLASH. So first, let's jump over to our browser here. Now, if any of you are not familiar with UNSPLASH, this is a website dedicated to sharing stock photography under the UNSPLASH license. Now, there are so many awesome images here by talented photographers, which you are able to use for free if you give credit to the photographer. For this video, I have put together a really cool list of amazing poster scene images you can use. And for this tutorial in particular, I'm going to be using this particular poster scene by Yonghyun Lee. If you want to get hold of this image and the list, you can find the link in the free index PDF document that accompanies this course, and in the info section of the video. Links are in the description. So this is a really cool image of a street poster scene, and I always love to superimpose my designs into this one. So first, I'll download the image and open it in Photoshop. I'll copy the image and hit Command N on Mac or Control N on Windows to create a new document. Now, in this instance, my proposal document is 1920 by 1080 for screen display, so I'll want to pop my image into this. So I'll set my doc to 1920 by 1080, click OK, and press Command V on Mac or Control V on Windows to paste. With my image inside, I'll come to my Layers panel and quickly set this to a smart object and resize so it fits nicely into the frame. Perfect. I'll double click into my smart object and zoom in. Now, I could pop my poster anywhere, but in this instance, I'll just pop it on top of this poster here. Next, I'll come over to the selection tool and just drag a shape over roughly the same size of this poster below. I'll press Command Shift N on Mac or Control Shift N on Windows to make a new layer. I'll make sure the foreground is set to white and I'll use the Paint Bucket tool to fill this in. With my new layer, I'll come and set this to a smart object. Next, I'll double click into my smart object, and now I have a space where I can place my artwork for my poster design. So in Illustrator, I'll come to my page where I show the logo on top of the treatment effect. I'll open the background I prepared earlier and drag it into my poster space. I'll resize and position. Then come back into my proposal doc, grab my logo design and paste it into my poster. Next, I'll add some type to my poster to complete my demo poster design. I'll hit close and save and quit. And now we are back into the poster scene. So that was just a quick way of how I can create my specific artwork and set it onto the poster image. So once I have my poster demo, I'll press Command T on Mac or Control T on Windows to free transform. I'll press and hold Command or Control on Windows and click on each corner and drag each into the corner of the poster below to cover nicely and press Enter. Now, it may not be perfect, so I'll come up to Edit, Transform, and click Warp. and then click and drag the handles to try and cover the poster below more accurately. Okay, so with our poster in place, two final things to do here to make it look a little bit more authentic. So first, with the selection tool, I'll just make a selection over the bottom right where the poster overlaps. With my poster layer selected, I'll press Command G on Mac or Control G on Windows to pop it into a group and hit the opacity mask at the bottom of the layers panel. That will chop that corner off and reveal the poster below. And finally, one last step. So over in the browser, if I go to search images, I'll type creased paper effect. This should give us a bunch of images with creased paper textures. So here I'll just grab a good one I think looks appropriate, and this one looks good. I'll right click, jump back into my poster, double click into the poster artwork to open that up again. I'll paste the creased paper effect on top, scale and position, and set the blending mode to multiply, and now that's added a cool creased effect. I'll press Command W on Mac or Control W on Windows to close and save, and back in the poster scene, that looks a little more natural. Perfect. So now it's just a case of saving the in-situ document, coming back into the logo proposal doc and placing the image into the document. Easy. So just like that, you can easily grab a really cool image from Unsplash and superimpose your work to show off your design for free. So thank you, Yonghyun Lee, for uploading that example to Unsplash. Don't forget, the link is in the description, to jump onto the page and grab the image. So when putting together your proposal document, consider using appropriate in-situ visuals, as this can really help sell your design and convince a client of its merits. So back in my proposal document, another really cool in-situ visual I like to show to the client is stickers, and how a logo can be used in a small, fun format. In the next video, I'm going to show you a really good sticker template you could invest in to show off your logo design in a fun way, and how to use it. So see you in the next video.